Kia ora everyone. Well, it's lovely to join you again in this week, the third week of October. There's so much happening in the Mana electorate. Last week I was delighted to officially open the new franchise of Kip McGrath in Tawa, because of course Linden is the most southern point of the Mana electorate, and James and Fitty Makwhare Mahihi are the new proud owners of that franchise in Tawa. And as I said at the opening, they combined three values that I'm very committed to. It's a very family oriented exercise with a husband and wife and all their children involved. It's a small business which they decided that they would go into and move away from the idea of investing in property, and the Minister of Finance, Bill English, will be very happy to hear that. And of course the third thing is that Kip McGrath is focused on raising educational competency and achievement amongst students, and so what that little business was about was all three of those very important values. So I congratulate James and Fitty, and I wish them all the very best in that endeavour in Tawa. Now, secondly, over the weekend, I was honoured to have the Prime Minister, the Right Honourable John Key, visit us in the northern part of the electorate. We started at the Kāpiti Uniting Church Fair up in Raumati. We met lots of wonderful people there. The Prime Minister signed autographs, had photos taken with children and their mothers and their fathers, and thoroughly enjoyed all of it. We left there on foot and walked around the Raumati village and dropped in on the hairdresser and the chemist, and for me a particularly joyful moment was coming around the corner and seeing the frock shop, which I have shopped at and shop at, and which has wonderful clothes and items of jewellery. And there in the window were mannequins dressed up with my Hekia Vote Parata t-shirts, and they were fashionably complemented by tights and jerseys and denim jackets, just showing what the flair of costuming and helping and advising women that shop has. So I encourage you to get along there and invest in a new item for your wardrobe. After that, we went down to Cafe Lembas, where Gail, the proud owner of that cafe, she and her chef won the Wellington on a Table prize for the Lembastic burger, and it is absolutely delicious. So do make a point of calling in at at Cafe Lembas. We went on from there down to Paikākāriki, and where we met Graham Coe, the chair of the fundraising effort for refurbishing the St. Peter's Hall, and had the opportunity to buy a calendar to support that effort, as well as to learn that Finn's, the wonderful hotel and cafe there, is going to invest in establishing a new mini cinema or movie theatre there early in the new year. So that will complement the resources and activities that are available in that wonderful village of Paikākāriki. We went on down to the Palmer's Garden Centre at Plimmerton, where we spoke to Richard and Eloise Person, who are the proud owners of that centre and who do a very, very good job. We were able to drop into the cafe there where the Prime Minister tested the toastie on sale there and declared it absolutely divine. And so, again, I encourage you to get there and experience that taste sensation. We dropped in on Jeff and his family at Living Headquarters to congratulate them on coming runner-up in the New Zealand Top Shop Awards for 2010. So there are wonderful items there. I know I'm sounding like a salesperson for all these little businesses in the northern part of the Mana electorate, but I unashamedly are. These are people who have all backed themselves, who are every day going out to work and contributing not only as business people to their communities, but as fathers and mothers and daughters and sons, and contributing to their part of our world. We left there and we visited Plimmerton on a whistle stop visit. We visited the Cafe Valor, which sells the most divine triple chocolate cheesecake, and we called in and spoke to all the dairy owner and the pizzeria owner. And I encourage you to also go there, because of course the weekend before was the relaunching of the Plimmerton railway station, so do make a point of going there to visit as well, and congratulate Alan Dodson and Dave Henderson and all the folk of Plimerton who put in over 2,000 voluntary hours to bring that station back to its present glory. From there, the Prime Minister and I went over to Pawatahanui, where we had the opportunity of a wonderful coffee at Ground Up Cafe. The barista there, Vince, and the cafe owner, Daryl, offer just the out-of-this-world coffee, so much so that it's the first coffee that I've had in almost 2 years, and I'm hooked again. We held a good old-fashioned New Zealand community meeting outside the rural trading post. We had about 140 people who'd come along to hear the Prime Minister and me talk about what the government's plans are in terms of economic management, in terms of our approach to growing the economy for New Zealand. And we took questions from people who stood on the gravel inside these great number 8 wire gates, the veranda of the cottage shop, which sells also some great products and jewellery and candles and oils and essences. So, you know, you should feel free to go there as well. People really appreciated that the Prime Minister was so available and so accessible. A young woman that we met in that crowd, Elizabeth, a Rotary student here as a guest of the Plimerton Rotary, told me that she had no hope of meeting even her congressman because they are always phalanxed by security personnel, whereas the New Zealand Prime Minister and our Prime Minister, John Key in particular, was so warm and so approachable and so interested, and Elizabeth got a photo with him and was absolutely delighted to let her hometown in Colorado know of this wonderful experience for her. So as you can see, it's been a very busy time in the Mana electorate, and I just want to finish by saying that the Porirua Business Awards are on next Friday. Partners Porirua and Westpac jointly collaborated to host the Porirua Young Employee of the Year process. 4 finalists emerged from that. They, together with all the businesses that have been part of this process, will be honoured and celebrated next week at the Chamber of Commerce Awards, where the Honourable Jerry Brownlee will be the guest of honour. So I look forward to meeting perhaps some more or many of you at those awards, and if not there, then in any wonderful spot around the Mana electorate. Have a great and safe Labour weekend. See you next week.